Hello children, how are y'all? Hope y'all are fine. So in previous class we have completed money lesson and today we will revise money lesson for your class test. So the class test will be conducted the next class itself and the test will be in Google form. Okay, so the questions will be in fill ups only. So I will tell you how the questions will be. Okay, so now we will revise children. Okay, first main, fill in the blanks. Dash is used to buy things. Yes, with help of money, isn't it? So money is used to buy things. Money is used to buy things. So the money is in two forms. Money or rupee we can tell. Rupees are used in how many forms? Two forms. So rupees are in how many forms children? Two forms. So first is coins and notes. Okay, coins and notes. Okay children, rupees are used in two forms. The money is used in two forms, that is coins and notes. Okay, the symbol of rupees is, you can write it as the symbol or you can write it as RS. Okay, the symbol of rupees is, either you can write the symbol or you can write RS. The symbol of paise is P, small P. Okay, the symbol of paise is what children? Small P. So the next is rupees 1 equals 100 paise. So in 1 rupee how many paises are there? There are 100 paises. Okay, in 1 rupee there are 100 paises. Okay, understood children? Once again we will repeat. Money is used to buy things. Rupees are used in two forms, coins and notes. The symbol of rupee is, either you can write the symbol or RS. The symbol of paise is P. Okay, so 1 rupee equals how many paises? 100 paises. Okay, 1 rupee equals 100 paises. Next one children, how many 5 rupees notes will make rupees 20. So in 20 rupees how many 5 rupees are there, that you have to find out. Okay, in 20 rupees how many 5 rupees are there? So you can either see how much by adding 5 rupees we can see how many 5 rupees are there. 5 plus 5 is 10, another 5 and another 5. Okay, so 5 plus 5 is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15, 15 plus 5 is 20. So either you can do like this, because you are adding the same number repeatedly, you can go with the multiplication, that is 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20. So there are 4 5 rupees note to get in 20 rupees. Okay, in 20 rupees. The same way, how many rupees 1 rupee will make 10 rupees. So in 10 rupees how many 1 rupee are there? 10 1 rupees are there. So you can just write the number 10. Okay, so here we use dot to separate rupees and paises, called as decimal point. So as I told you before, for example, if you have 23 rupees and 45 paise, that how you should write? 23 rupees dot 45 paise. So the dot separates the rupees and paise, where before the dot is called rupees and after the dot is called paise. Okay. Addition of money. So the question can be in this form and or in this form. Okay, in these two forms only the question can be, anyway, because it is a Google form. You have to arrange and then you should add. Okay, you should work out in your RNB book and find out the answer. Then you have to click. In both the questions, you have to arrange it. Okay, so add rupees 25 and 50 paise plus rupees 25 and 50 paise. So first, what you should do children, you should write the symbol, rupees symbol and paise symbol. Okay, so now write this number below this. Rupees number should come below the sign. Keep the dot. Don't forget to keep the dot. And next you should write
below P, what you should write? Should write paise. Few children are not writing the sign. The sign is very important. It tells you what you should do. Whether you should add, whether you should subtract, or whether you should multiply. Sign is very important. So what is the next number? 25 rupees dot, write the decimal point, and 50 rupees. Now we will add. Okay, now we will add. 0 plus 0 is how much, children? 0. 5 plus 5, 5 in your mind, 5 show it in your finger. After 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 means what you should do? In Pisces place, you should have only 2 numbers. You should not have more than 2 numbers. Okay, if you have more than 2 numbers, what you should do? You should take the carry over. So as it is 10, what I am going to do is, I am going to write here 0 and 1, I am going to take it as carry over. And after this 2 numbers only, you should keep the dot. Okay, because this is separate and this is separate, don't write the 1 year itself. You should take the carry over. How you are adding, the same way only you should add. Now you add, children. Once again, 5 plus 5 is how much? 10. 10 plus 1 is how much? 11. So 11, 1 I am writing here. 1 I take it as carry over. 2 plus 1 is how much? 3. 3 plus 2 is 3 in your mind. To show it in your finger. After 3, 4, 5. So what is the total rupees? Total rupees how much? 51.0 paise. No need to tell that 0 paise. You can just tell fraction of money. So in these two forms only the question will be. Subtract rupees 54 and 50 paise minus rupees 34 and 50 paise. Here it is given directly. Okay. So keep in your mind, in subtraction always what you should come first. Big number should come first. As I told you early, the big number should come first. So subtract minus means directly you can write first number, write the sign, second number should come down and you can subtract. Okay, now we will subtract, children. First what you should do, write the symbol of rupee and paise. Next, write the rupees, how much it is, write below the sign, and paise below P. Okay, 54 rupees and 50 paise minus rupees 34 and 50 paise. Okay, now we will subtract. 0 minus 0 is how much? 0 minus 0 is 0. 5 minus 0 is how much? 5 minus 0 is also 0. So 5 in your mind, 5 show it in your finger. Before 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. So you can write here the answer 0. Now 4 minus 4, once again 4 minus 4. 4 in your mind, 4 show it in your finger. Before 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. So here also you should write 0. Now 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 is how much, children? Sorry, 5 minus 3. 5 minus 3 is how much, children? 2. So how much it is left over? How much is the difference? 20 rupees is the difference. The next is, from rupees 27 and 50 paise, subtract 12 rupees and 50 paise. This is the one form, children. Another one is subtract 12 rupees and 50 paise from 27 rupees and 50 paise also can be asked. This way also can be asked. In subtraction we have learned now. So in that way also can be asked. But the meaning is same. The from number should always come first. Okay, you should write here. Or the big number, from the big number only you have to subtract. So from means this is the from. From this you are going to subtract this number. Okay, so write the symbol first. Rupees, paise, from number should come first. Wherever it is, subtract 12 rupees from 27 rupees, or from 27 rupees, subtract 12 rupees, 50 paise. Both the meaning are same. Okay. Write 27 below rupees symbol and 50 paise below P. Next, write the sign. Next, 12 rupees 50 paise. Okay, now we can subtract. 0 minus 0 is 0 5 minus 5 is 0. 7 minus 2, 7 in your mind, 2 show it in your finger. Before 7, 6, 5. So write here 5, 2 minus 1 is 1. Don't forget to keep the decimal point and write the rupees sign. Okay, understood children? So in these two forms only the question word problem children. So only the amount I will change. Okay, so the only the amount I will change, remaining everything is same, so that it is easy to understand for you. Okay, so in, as I told you, in word problem we have to find whether we should add or subtract. Okay, so you need, first one, you need to collect rupees 15 from Tina and 30 rupees from Tarun. How much money will you get in total? So you and Tarun. So how much total you have? That means you have to add the amount and you have to find out how much is there in total. Total means you have to add. So money from Tina. Write leave two lines here. And you can start writing this. Money from Tina equals, write the rupees symbol and paise, leave one line here. If you get the carryover, you can write here. So only I am telling you to leave two lines. One line for the symbol and one line for the carryover. If you get, okay, or if you want to borrow, that you can write it in this line. So money from Tina. How much you are collecting from Tina? Rupees 15.00. So money from Tarun. How much you are collecting from Tarun? How much children? 30 rupees. Rupees 30. Do you have paise? No. So total money. Total money equals how much? How much is there totally? Now we will find out. Write the symbol. Few children are not writing the symbol there. So it is very important that you should write the symbol. Now we will add. 0 plus 0 is how much children? 0. 0. Once again here. 5 plus 0 is 5. 3 plus 1 is 4. So you have 45 rupees in total. Okay. So after collecting 15 rupees from Tina and 30 rupees from Tarun, how much you have? You have rupees 45. You can work out this in your RNB and you can click the answer. You are going to a shop to get a bat and a ball. Okay. The bat cost rupees 10 and ball cost rupees 30. How much will you pay the shopkeeper in total? Okay. So how much will you pay the shopkeeper in total? So you want to buy bat and a ball. So how much will you give to the shopkeeper? So you have to know the amount of the both the things together. So what is the total will be? So you have to add. So what you will write? Cost of bat equals, write the symbol, equals cost of bat. What is the cost of bat children? Rupees 10. Do you have paise? No. So just write two dots and two zeros. Okay. So cost of ball. Ball cost rupees how much children? Rupees 30. Okay. So rupees 30. Total equals how much? So what sign I should write children? Plus. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. Keep the dot. 0 plus 0 is 0. 3 plus 1 is 4. So how much it costs totally? Bat and ball together. It costs rupees 40. Okay. It costs rupees 40. Next one. Hanu has rupees 20. And ice cream costs rupees 50. Okay. So Hanu, how much she has? She has 20 rupees. She wants to buy an ice cream. It costs rupees 50. She wants to know how much money she will have left after she buys the ice cream. So after buying the ice cream, how much will be left over? She wants to know. So first is money she has. So how much she has children? 20 rupees. 0 paise. So here whether we have to add or we have to subtract. See children, here she wants to buy 15 rupees ice cream. She has 20 rupees. After giving the money, how much is left over she have to find out. So when you subtract only, you can find out how much is left over. So write minus sign and write the cost of ice cream. Cost of ice cream equals 15 rupees. Okay, now we will subtract. Okay, so 0 minus 0 is how much? 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. Keep the dot. 0 minus 5. Can you subtract, children? We can take. Can you subtract? So, no. What you should do? You should borrow 1. Here it will be 1 and here also it will be 10. Okay? So, here 10 minus 5 is how much? 5. Here you have 1 minus 1 is 0. So, here you have rupees 5. So, left out money is rupees 5. Okay? Understood, children, how we have to do? So, the next one, children. A pencil cost rupees 5 and a eraser cost rupees 10. You have 10 rupees with you. Okay. The first part is how much will it cost to buy pencil and eraser. So, the first part what you have to find out is you have to find out how much it will cost when you buy both the things. That is pencil and eraser. So, first write cost of pencil equals, write here rupees sign, paise. How much it costs, children? Rupees 5. Okay. Rupees 5, 0, paise. Cost of eraser equals how much rupees? Eraser cost rupees 2. So, now total spent equals how much? How much are going to spend? 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. Keep the dot. 5 plus 2 is 7. So, rupees 7 you are going to spend. Okay? Understood, children? So, the next one, children. Part 2. How much change will you get back if you buy only the pencil? Okay? So, they have asked, if you buy only the pencil, how much money will be left over? You have 10 rupees, right? So, if you buy only the pencil, how much will be left over with you? So, we have to subtract the amount you have minus the product what which you are going to buy. Okay, suppose if the question is how much will be money will be left over with you after buying the pencil and eraser, means the amount which you have got, that amount you have to subtract as we did in the government textbook. Okay, as we did in the government textbook, what we will do, we will add and how much money will be left over, we will find by subtracting the amount how much we have got, right? But the question here is, if we buy only to find out, if you buy only the pencil, how much will be left over? So, part 2, amount you have. Amount you have. How much you have? How much you have? You have 10 rupees. Right here. Rupees 10, 0, 0. So, amount pencil equals, how much is the cost of pencil, children? Rupees 5. So, amount left we have to find out how much weight is left over. What is the sign I should write? Minus. Okay, now we will subtract, children. 0 minus 0 is 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. 0 minus 5. Can you subtract, children? No. So, we have to take 1 from the, because here is only 1. So, I am doing, I don't need not to cancel and take. I am taking the both the numbers together. So, 10 minus 5. 10 in your mind. 5 show it in your finger. Before 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. So, you can write the answer 5. Rupees 5 is left over. Okay. Understood, children? Rupees 5 is left over. Okay, children. Practice all the mains from your textbook, all in one book. And you can refer the government textbook also. Okay. You can refer the government textbook and CW. Prepare well and do the test well. Okay. Take care. Bye.